Hello everyone and welcome back to another Vectornator tutorial. I'm your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. This time around I'll teach you how to create a vector badge, an idea perhaps you can use for your print work. We will explore tools inside of Vectornator, we'll put together shapes and curves, export our final vector badge in different file formats, and test our final work in other desktop applications. So inside Vectornator, let's go ahead and create a new document. So on the top right corner, I'm going to tap on the plus icon and I'm going to choose one of the presets Vectornator comes with. In this case, I'm going to choose the A4 size. And now inside an empty document, the first thing I'm going to do is to tap on the top left corner to get to the settings inspector. So tap on the gear icon and here I'm going to change a couple of settings for this vector badge tutorial. First, I'm going to toggle off the visibility of the rulers, since we're not going to be using any guides for this Vectornator tutorial. But at the same time, I'm going to toggle on the visibility for the white background. That is always a good idea so we can see our work. Now we're going to start creating the vector badge by using the star tool. So in order to get to the star tool inside of Vectornator, you want to tap on the rectangle tool. Then the contextual menu will appear, so tap on the three dots and you will see the rest of the Vectornator shape tools. In this case, go ahead and tap on the star tool. The star tool will always draw from the center and outwards. So let us go ahead and do that by tapping and dragging from the center and towards the outside. Now this is not the shape we will be using. Instead, we're going to adjust how pointy the star is and create all sorts of different shapes by pinching in the points. And by points, I mean the five star points, which of course can be adjusted at any later time. Now I want to spend a couple of minutes here and show you how this star tool works and get the hang of it. So I'm going to tap and drag, place another finger on the canvas at the same time. This way, you can adjust how pointy the star can get. When you release the extra finger you placed on the canvas, that means you have set the star shape, and then you can size the star up or you can size the star down. So now up in the Options Inspector, I'm going to tap on the trace icon and delete that. Now, in the event you want to return to the original star shape, you will need to tap and drag. Place another finger on the canvas at the same time, and you're going to pinch this in. As you do, you will feel a snap, which means you're back on the default star shape. Now release the extra finger you placed on the canvas and scale the star. Alright, let's go ahead and delete that again, and this time around I'll change the number of star points from 5 to 16, and I'm going to draw a different pointy star. So I'm creating a new star by placing an extra finger on the canvas and pinching this in like so. Now I'm going to return back to the settings inspector and under the snapping options, I'm going to turn the smart guides on because I want to center this on the canvas by tapping on the selection tool to align the star horizontally and vertically center. I'm also going to scale the star one more time by selecting the scale tool like so. Now before I go to the next step, because I like to be organized, I'm going to the Layers panel and I'm going to rename Layer 1 to Star. And then I will tap on the lock icon to lock the star layer so I don't accidentally move it. Alright, let's go ahead and create a new layer by tapping on the new layer icon, which is the Layer 1. Tap on that, so you make sure that you're working on that layer. Now we're going to use the polygon tool. So tap again on the star tool, tap on the three dots to get to the other shape tools, and from there tap on the polygon tool. So tap and drag to create a polygon shape, which I will move it to the center like so. Under the style inspector, I'm going to change certain parameters. So for the number of sides, right now it is set to 8. I'm going to bring the number down to 6 sides. I'm also going to increase the corner radius from 0 to 30%. so I have some kind of a roundness. And then I'm going to give it a color. So I'm going to tap on the fill color, and I'm going to give it a random color that would probably change later on. I'm also going to make sure that I activate the stroke. And for the stroke width, I will set it to 8 points instead of 6 points, like so. And so that is the first polygon. Now let's go ahead and create another polygon. But first I'm going to tap and rename the layer one to polygons. Hit enter return. So here is the first polygon. Okay, so I'm going to select that. And up on the options inspector, I'm going to tap the copy icon to copy, and then tap the paste icon to paste the second polygon. So now we have two identical polygons. For the second polygon, I'm going to tap on the scale tool, and I'm going to size this down. I'm also going to change the stroke color to a bit of white, and I will change the stroke width to 4, like so. Now I'm going to make another copy from the second polygon. So up in the options inspector, tap the copy icon to copy, and then tap the paste icon to paste the third polygon. So in this case, I'm going to tap on the scale tool, and I'm going to size this down even more. Now I'm going to go ahead and change its color to, let's say, this one. And I'm going to leave it as is for now. I can also change the stroke width to 6, and I'm going to scale this down just a bit more. And these are pretty much the three polygon shapes I will be using for this layer and for this vector badge. For this next step, I'm going to create one more polygon and use it as a base to create a custom shape out of it. So up in the options inspector, I will tap the copy icon to copy, and then tap the paste icon to paste it. Now I'm going to create a new layer by tapping on the new layer icon, which is going to be layer one. Then I'm going to tap and hold and bring in the last polygon inside the layer one. I'm also going to lock the polygons layer, and I'm going to toggle off its visibility. And I will do the same for the star layer so I can focus on this new custom shape. Alright, so no need to have a stroke for this new shape. I'm actually going to use the node tool, and I'm going to marquee select those top four nodes, which I'm going to remove them. So up in the options inspector, I'm going to tap the trash icon to remove those four nodes. Now when I marquee select those two endpoints, you can see those nodes do have a control handle. So in this case, I'm going to remove those control handles by creating a corner point. So all you have to do inside VectorNator is to double tap on top of each node. So double tap with the node tool and double tap again. So let's go ahead and marquee select those two nodes and move them downwards a bit. So first of all, I will go ahead and change the shape's color. I'm also going to toggle on the visibility of the polygons layer so I can see what I'm doing in relation with the rest of the custom shape. Again, I'm going to marquee select the nodes using the node tool, and then I'm going to move them downwards using the joystick, which is at the very bottom of the canvas. So I'm going to tap and hold the down arrow key to move those nodes pixel by pixel, like so. So now with the selection tool, I will select the shape, then tap on the scale tool to scale it down and place it close to the edges of the other polygon. So let's go ahead and create a bunch of vertical lines, thin lines with a very small space in between, which they will cut through the custom shape we created earlier. So let me show you what I mean. To make sure that I draw a perfectly vertical line, I'm going to get the help of the VectorNator grid. So inside the settings inspector and under the grid, tap on the perpendicular grid option. And then under the snapping options, I'm going to turn on snap to grid. Now, all we have to do is tap to select the pen tool and lay down two nodes, two anchor points, one here and one there. And now we know this is a perfectly straight line. So let's go back to the settings inspector. I'm going to turn off snap to grid as well as hide the grid like so. Now inside the style inspector right now, we have a fill color and that is the reason we cannot see anything. So I'm going to swap between the fill and the stroke by tapping on the icon here. And for the stroke width, 8 points seems to be too much. So I'm going to bring this down to 2 points and place it over. Now I'm going to duplicate the vertical line. So I will activate the duplicate mode, which is the second icon on the contextual menu. So I'm going to tap and drag, place another finger on the canvas at the same time, which acts like a shift key, and create that extra vertical line. Now make sure you tap on the duplicate icon again to disable it, because it's going to continue creating more duplicates over duplicates. So under the Arrange Inspector, and all the way at the bottom, we're going to use the Duplicate and Transform Again command. So I'm going to keep tapping on that till I create a bunch of these vertical lines that will cut through the custom shape. Now I think we have enough vertical lines to cover over the shape, but we do need one more step here. These vertical lines are basically vertical stroke lines. So we need to turn them into objects, into shape lines. So under the Path Inspector, I'm going to tap on the Outline command, like so. Now I'm going to move those lines on top of the shape. So using the joystick again, I'm going to make sure that I'm very close to the edges of the shape under. Now, looking at the layers panel here, I have both the polygons and the star layer locked because with the selection tool, I'm going to marquee select those lines and paths as well as the shape. And then inside the path inspector, I'm going to use the second Boolean operation, the subtract Boolean operation, and cut the shape through those vertical lines like so. So now let's go ahead and add a bit of a text to give a message to our vector badge. So I'm going to rename layer 1 to lines, hit enter, return, and then I'm going to tap on the lock icon to lock the layer so I don't accidentally move it. So let's go ahead and create a new layer by tapping on the new layer icon. And then I'm going to use the rectangle tool and tap and drag to create one like so. I'm going to change the fill color to perhaps this off-white color. And for the stroke, this green color is just fine for now. I'm also going to make this just a little thinner and reduce its height. In this case, now we just have a flat rectangle, but I want to have a bit of a curve to it. So I'm going to add two additional nodes, two additional anchor points. So I'm going to tap on the node tool and I'm going to add one node along this path and another node along that path. In this case, those two anchor points, those two nodes are corner points. So we need to turn them into smooth points. So each will have two control handles so we can have a nice curved path. So all we have to do is just double tap on each of the anchor points, like so. Now we're going to move these smooth points a bit upwards here and create a nice curved rectangle, something along those lines. So I'm going to lock this curve and tap on the pen tool to create a curved path. So I'm going to tap and drag on this left edge, and then I'm going to tap and drag on the right edge. Now, no need to have a fill color for the curve, just a stroke color to be able to just see the curve basically. And I'm going to use the node tool to edit the shape of the curve, because we're going to place text on top of that curve. So I'm going to tap on the text tool, tap and drag to create a text field, and here I'm going to type my own message. Feel free, of course, to use your own message for your own vector badge, like so. Now under the style inspector, I'm going to change the fill color to perhaps this gray color, and I can increase the tracking value to 50 and get a bit of space in between letters. So now I'm going to marquee select both my text and the curve with the selection tool, and inside the path inspector and all the way at the bottom, I'm going to use the place text on path command, like so. Now I'm going to use those handles to move the text to the center and just place it in a better way. Now another thing we can do is to go back to the curve, use the node tool to adjust that curve till we have a nice curve path, something along those lines. So what you see here is the final version of the vector badge. And all I did was to add a background, I changed the color of the star, I inserted my own logo, as well as play around a bit adjusting the curve. So now let's go ahead and export this vector badge inside Vectornator. So for that, I'm going to tap on the top left corner, tap on the export icon, and inside the export inspector, we are presented with a lot of export options. So if I were to send this to the printer, I would definitely choose the PDF option. That will print the vector badge perfectly fine. Of course, you can use your Creative Cloud membership, the Adobe Creative Cloud membership. But another great option here is the SVG export option. Now, SVG stands for Scalable Vector Graphics, especially if you want to open your work in other vector applications. So inside the SVG export dialog box, we also have the choice to create outlines from text. Well, that all depends where you're sending your work. So now let's go ahead and jump into the desktop and see how the PDF and SVG file work in other software applications. So here is the PDF file I exported inside of Vectornator. As you can see, it looks great and it's ready to be printed. Let's go ahead and see how the SVG file works inside Adobe Illustrator. As you can see, the layers were imported perfectly fine and names were preserved. And the same story continues with the Affinity Designer, where everything was preserved the way it was supposed to. Thank you for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.